What in the world could she be doing? One more wasted evening. One can only speculate what the excuse would be this time.
Hello, darling, it's me. Obviously, you're not there. I can't think where you might be. But anyway, as I was saying...
If you've quite finished criticizing my absence, might want to inquire as to your whereabouts? No, let me guess. Another one of your meetings, am I right?
Yes, look, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to be able to make it.
No, I'm sure you're bound and gagged and won't be released till you've revealed every last item. After all, everyone knows Tupperware parties are renowned for that type of violence.
Darling, you're the one who said I should find something to get me out of the house, gain a little independence.
And becoming the local Tupperware tycoon was the answer? Still not to worry. Knowing your business sense, I'm sure I'll be the one left picking up the pieces when you manage to come home penniless yet again.
It's hardly the first time it's happened. I do think you could at least try and understand. I don't know why you're making such a fuss.
Oh, just a tiny matter of our anniversary. You really could have made an effort to get home early tonight.
Darling, does it have to be tonight?
I have tickets for the opera.
Oh, it's hardly the end of the world.
No, but... I've had the tickets for the last 3 weeks. It's already 6 o'clock. And thanks to you, it was too late to get the tickets to someone who just might appreciate them. And instead of lighting the candles in our cake, maybe I'd be better off trying to rekindle our marriage.
Darling, I'm hanging up the phone before your grumpy mood rubs off on me. And ruins my whole presentation.
You'll manage that without my help. Try not to be too late. Well, the way things are going, looks like the champagne, foie gras, and stroganoff are gonna leave out to a TV dinner and a Diet Coke. Either that or a lovingly prepared dinner on tête-à-tête with myself. Well, at least I won't sulk all evening. And there is, of course, the added bonus of not having to endure the trials and tribulations in the jet-setting lives of the local Tupperware Mafia. Next door again? What'll be this time? A cup of sugar? Or maybe just a good snoop? Just a minute! Yes?
Good evening, sir. Rick Fuel. Here to save you.
Save me? Am I in danger?
Rats, cockroaches, ants. Don't tell me you've never been bothered by any of life's little unwelcome guests.
Indeed. And you're forgetting one.
And that would be?
Door-to-door salesman. Goodbye.
But wait, sir, I...
Got something out of that, at least. All right, just a second. I was only joking. You forgot your pen.
Thank you.
Will this take long?
It'll be very brief.
That long. Well, I suppose I could use the company.
No, I assure you, it'll just be a minute.
Don't waste your breath. I've heard it all before.
May I?
Well, since you're halfway in already, if I shut the door now, you'll lose a leg. So enter. At your own risk.
I've been known to live dangerously.
Just the same. If you think I'm going to fall for whatever it is you're selling, I'm afraid you're wasting your time.
Well, if that's the case, I think we both are.
Whatever. I have nothing to lose and everything to gain. As you can see, I'm dining alone this evening.
Were you waiting for someone?
I stopped waiting long ago.
Oh, well, in that case, I can...
Be my guest. Be as convincing as you can. I just love being treated like I was born yesterday.
Well, I must admit, I find your approach somewhat...
Surprising? Unconventional. Or maybe just honest. After all, we should both try to remain in character. Yours being hypocrisy. Shall we proceed?
Very well, But I must say, you're throwing me a little.
Enough! I want to see you in action. Don't let a little criticism throw you off your game. A drink, maybe?
No, I don't think
vodka,
I should drink.
Vodka, whiskey?
Tomato juice.
Whiskey, tomato juice?
No, just tomato juice.
New one on me. Whiskey, tomato juice? It is. presume it's your first time.
Yeah, nothing escapes you.
Now, you must remain 100% confident no matter what I think. Beginner though you obviously are, you should try to make me feel like your umpteenth conquest.
If you say so.
Get on with it.
Very well. Very nice place you have here. I like your taste.
Nice?
Yes. Yes, please.
Yes, very flattering. Spend a few months living here, you'll soon change your mind. However, if your compliments are an attempt to get me on your side, not bad at all. You're already feeling your feet.
Well, if you don't like it, why not just make some changes?
Well, unfortunately, I'm not the only king of this castle.
You're married.
Perfect. Your answer, that is. Not my marriage, but that's another story. Do go on. Cheers to future contracts.
To our future contracts.
Don't count your chickens just yet. There'll be plenty of time for raising their glasses when, or indeed, if we do strike a deal.
Okay. First thing is first. Allow me to just introduce myself. Like I said earlier, my name is Rick Fuel, representing Inferno, a specialist in the elimination of insects, rodents, or just about any parasite known to man.
Oh, original. And?
Just one second. We have developed a foolproof method that guarantees the permanent elimination of all unwelcome intruders without the slightest risk to the customer. And,
Very reassuring. So we're not talking about some kind of atomic bomb here.
And we guarantee a result.
Well, I should hope so. Why else would anyone use your services?
Well, what I mean is that we guarantee there'd be no need for any further intervention.
Well, surely that level of efficacy can't be good for future business.
Oh, there's no shortage of undesirable creatures ready and willing to fill any vacancy.
Ha ha! I see you met the new neighbors.
And you've been here for?
8 years.
In 8 years, you've never been bothered with woodworm.
Never. Woodworm don't seem to share my wife's appreciation in tasting a Kia.
Mites.
Look for yourself. Not a single carpet. My wife's allergic.
To carpet?
To good taste.
Mice? Rats?
Not a single rodent. With the exception of my late hamster.
Oh, my sincere condolences.
Well, he died young. I never really got to know him.
But sometimes it's better that way.
Like with children.
Cockroaches. I have yet to meet a single city dweller who's not battled with cockroaches at least once in their life.
The building is treated every 3 months, and if your product works that well, the building will become insect-free at my expense.
Quiet. So that's a no.
I don't think I've ever come across one. Not sure I'd even recognize one if I did.
Well, then it is possible.
I guess we'll never know.
Ants, maybe.
In Manhattan? Unless my wife has secretly been picnicking on the living room floor.
No other irritating little vermin?
On every floor, as you'll soon discover while prospecting. But eliminating my neighbors might not be that good for business.
Well, at this rate, I don't really see how I could be of any more use.
Now that would be a shame. I was rather enjoying your company.
Well, I'm sure there must be something I can interest you in.
Well, I don't doubt that for a second, although earlier on you did mention you're here to save me, but I'm sure you agree, at least for the moment, that I don't appear to be in imminent danger.
Well, just work with me. I know there's something gnawing at you, and if there is, I know I have the solution right here. Wait.
How very merry, Poppins.
What can I save you from?
Well, aside from my marriage, I really don't know.
Oh, troubles in the marriage department. Joined a club, huh?
I think I'm damned for all eternity.
If you only knew what you were saying.
I beg your pardon?
I mean, I don't really know what you mean. You're not being very clear, but I'm getting the distinct impression that your wife is making your life somewhat unbearable.
Got it in one.
Well, what could she have done that makes her any worse than anybody else's wife? Take mine, for example.
What could she have done? I'll tell you what she's done. She married me. That's what she done. All the others left me alone.
Was that her?
How shrewd. I can see one can't hide anything from you. The wedding dress is a dead giveaway.
Well, you could have done a lot worse.
Alas, we are not the only ones to have noticed that.
See. But she is a very attractive woman.
Beauty is like love. It fades with time. She's still very beautiful, but in my mind, she's still my wife, and no amount of beauty can hide that fact.
That's a little harsh, maybe.
Just facing the facts, as the passion fades, one's eyes are opened.
Were you that blinded by her?
No. I just woke up one morning and realized something I've always known but never wanted to admit.
And that was?
She's a gold digger. I even suspect her of refusing to have my child so that she'll never have to share in her inheritance if something should happen to me.
Well, if you knew that, why did you even marry her?
Well, you said yourself how attractive she is. She offered me her beauty. I gave her stability. A bargain, wouldn't you agree? I'll bet a fool's bargain.
Well, wait, I don't follow. You are married, after all, so in a way you become an owner of that beauty, right?
Well, I might be the owner, but I never benefit from it. She's never here. Even this evening, we should be celebrating 9 years of marriage, and apparently she's at some party demonstrating her little plastic boxes, and I, on the other hand, find myself abandoned with nothing more than a door-to-door cockroach killer. No offense.
None taken. I think you need more than just saving, though.
There's at least one consolation. At least when she's off groaning with somebody else, she's not sitting here moaning to me.
Now, very depressing.
Can't think of why I'm telling all this to a complete stranger.
I'm quite used to it.
What are you, some kind of door-to-door psychiatrist?
No, just a salesman. But I get this kind of thing all the time.
Do people have no shame?
No, seemingly not. We've known each other for 20 minutes and already...
And here I was thinking how one-off and original I was being.
You would not believe the people I come across in this job. I've met natures that expose less of themselves.
Well, I think at least they need to leave something to the imagination.
So why not divorce?
Don't beat around the bush, Mike, Al.
Forgive me, I just thought if we're...
Think nothing of it.
So why not then?
To continue maintaining her without the slightest effort on her part? Never. I'll just have to grin and bear it. I mean, I'll held hostage by an irrevocable heir of my youth. What's so funny? Youth. I'm a late bloomer.
I was not laughing about that at all. But I find it very interesting how you seem to take it all with a pinch of salt while others would be positively seething. Hey, see, now you're the one laughing.
Something just dawned on me. Huh? Well, maybe having cockroaches wouldn't be such a bad idea after all. At least they can be gotten rid of.
That's very amusing. I see what you mean, but you can't be serious.
I don't follow.
You've already thought about killing your wife.
I beg your pardon?
I was asking if the idea of killing your wife had ever crossed your mind.
What kind of question is that?
I mean, you were speaking as if. I mean, if you wanted to, or you were contemplating murder.
No! Whatever gave her that idea? I mean, no more than anybody else. Can anyone honestly say it's never once crossed their minds?
Right.
Of course, it has crossed my mind. Yours too, I imagine.
Right.
Crossed my mind a few times.
Right.
But fortunately, good sense prevails and prevents one acting on it. Although, the problems still persist. I guess it's just fate.
Wrong.
I beg your pardon?
You are wrong. Well, I'll tell you why you assume it's just fate. Firstly, all these inherited moral conditions. Thou shalt not kill, and so on, although that one doesn't seem to bother us in wartime. Secondly, fear. Fear of the law, or fear of getting caught in the act and having to explain one's actions.
Well, I suppose you're not that wrong. So?
So, imagine that these fears were no longer an obstacle. Then nothing would stand in your way.
I suppose not. But we are just speaking hypothetically.
Well, for now.
For now.
We're sidetracking. Yeah, I think I've taken up enough of your time.
No, wait, stay for another drink at least?
No, I don't think so. I do have a living to make, and you're not all that interested, so.
Well, maybe because you're not selling the right products.
Well, then maybe another whiskey. This time without the tomato juice.
Coming up. What did you mean about for now?
I simply meant things could change. You're the one speaking all metaphorically. I was asking a very straightforward question. Could you handle the guilt?
I couldn't say, although maybe the satisfaction would be enough to...
So the temptation is there.
Well, along with doubt and fear and... What exactly are you suggesting?
I'm simply trying to make you realize that when I said earlier I was here to save you, wasn't just my sales pitch.
Well, if you're planning on killing my wife, I really think your sales pitch has gone quite far enough.
Nothing of the kind. I'm simply a humble salesman representing a company specializing in the elimination of vermin. However, I do have one solution here that might be of interest.
Might be of interest?
Well, then I do say might at the very moment at least, because right now I'm not all that convinced.
Quit
really
beating around the bush and cut to the chase.
Have a look at this.
And this is?
Satisfied clients. Each and every one of them praising our methods of vermin elimination, if you know what I mean. Of course, one does have to read between the lines.
Fascinating.
Convinced?
Enticed.
Decided.
One can be enticed without succumbing. I mean, this all looks well on paper, but that's just the hype. I mean, there are still a few dark areas.
And they are.
Well, I presume this miraculous method doesn't come cheap.
You know what? I'm just coming to that very point. You'd be surprised.
Really?
It doesn't come cheap.
Huh. You're right. I am surprised. By your honesty.
You'll get used to it.
So, how much?
100,000.
I beg your pardon?
I didn't warn you.
But that's outrageous!
And killing your wife isn't.
I really don't understand. Who are you?
Like I said earlier, I'm here to save you. I'm your savior.
Seriously, why ever would I want to kill my wife?
I don't know. You brought it up.
No, I didn't. It was you.
Huh? There was no obligation. I was just listening.
But if you hadn't brought it up, the thought never even would have entered my mind.
But it had crossed your mind more than once.
With a little help from you.
Help! That is the very reason I'm here.
What exactly are you selling?
All I have to offer is freedom. The art of ridding oneself of a cumbersome wife. You do want to rid yourself of your wife, true?
I admit, the idea is somewhat appealing, but however, this all remains still a fantasy. Killing her my dreams is one thing. Bumping her off for real would be quite another. This might sound ridiculous amidst what can only be described as a somewhat macabre conversation, but I'm actually in love with my wife.
You know what? That's the secret. To remove one's wife without the slightest of suspicions, one would have to love her. Neither too much nor too little. Just enough to remain above all suspicion. Loving her too much, on the other hand, would raise all sorts of troublesome suspicions of a crime of jealousy and so on. Indifference. It's really the only way.
You want to sell me my wife's murder?
Not exactly. The execution of our method would be down to you. However, thanks to our method, no detail would be overlooked. We've even prepared a psychological preparation for any sort of last-minute hesitations, suspicions, remorse. Our detailed method guarantees the desired results with no unnecessary effort, no careless mistakes, and without the slightest risk of investigation.
How can I be sure?
Oh, you can't. Most of our clients tend not to brandish their satisfaction, if you know what I mean. Unless, of course, you count those you read about earlier, which weren't really eliminating cockroaches, after all. But don't take my word for it.
I won't.
Have another look.
Who would have imagined what was behind all of this?
Certainly not you. I couldn't have dropped any more hints.
Your brochure resembles some kind of memorial monument.
That's convincing, huh?
Extraordinary.
So I'm as Am I as bad a salesman as you thought I was?
Well, I bow to you. But I'm bowing out of your offer. Who's gonna pay $100,000 just to learn how to kill his wife when you could hire the first money-grabbing thug you come across to do it for less? Some of your clients might have more money than sense, but I tend to take pride in the latter.
Now, the price does seem high at first, I grant you. Of course you could find yourself a volunteer to remove your wife for $15,000, $20,000, but that's without a guarantee of a result, or even an attempt. There are many an unscrupulous criminal more than willing to provide the cash rather than to provide the service. There are even those who would go as far as to negotiate a higher price with the spouse in question. Then, of course, there are all the extras.
Extras?
Oh, to either buy the silence of your employee or to eliminate them, which would mean hiring another crook and so on. I assure you the long-term investment will be far more expensive. Our price not only includes our infallible method, but a whole host of tailor-made alibis in the event that your imagination deserts you. We do, however, draw the line at any sort of legal assistance, which I'm sure you'll appreciate.
Well, including a little legal assistance in the deal could be useful.
Well, it wouldn't be fair on our part because you would never need it.
Of course, but there's still the matter of the $100,000. She doesn't cost me that much alive, although Lord only knows how she managed to spend my money the way she does. Just check out her wardrobe.
Well, considering what you'd be saving, I would consider that an investment.
Well, I'm afraid my enthusiasm is somewhat dampened. With a stroke of luck, maybe some careless bus driver will come along and do the job for me free of charge.
Is that a firm refusal?
Very firm.
But not final.
For this evening, at least. I need time to think about it. I don't want to do anything hastily, so I'll sleep on it. Although, I'm not sure she'll be doing much sleeping tonight. She'll come home late, and I'll end up with even more time in my hands to contemplate your offer.
I'll leave you my card.
Oh, no, you don't. No, you don't. With my luck, she'll come across it, and the next thing I know, she'll be emptying my account to pay for exactly what I'm planning for her. Here, take mine. It's my cell phone. Call me tomorrow.
Well then, us. Speak tomorrow. Enjoy the murder.
I beg your pardon?
In your dreams. I almost forgot your pen.
But this isn't my pen.
No?
I've never seen it before.
I wonder how it got here.
I was persuaded it was a ploy to ensure that I called you back.
No, but that's an interesting idea. I'll save it for next time. Of course, I didn't need to use it.
Why not?
Well, I didn't just knock on anybody's door.
I'm sorry, I don't follow.
Simple intuition. And I wasn't wrong. Hmm?
Whatever you say, so I'll be hearing from you?
You most certainly will. Bye now.
Goodbye. I doubt that very much. Murdering my wife. Now my dream is shattered. How ridiculous.
Though.
more depressing.
It's soothing.
Don't you mean boring, darling? It's like being in a church.
Well, maybe it's an attempt, albeit in vain, to round up those who have strayed. Although, if the Pope hasn't managed it in 30 years, I don't fancy my chances in 10 minutes.
Do let me know when you finally decide to say something sensible.
Likewise, if you ever decide to understand anything requiring a minimum of intelligence.
Is it me, or are you particularly unpleasant today?
And is it me, or has the penny finally dropped?
May I inquire what is going on?
Don't you even have an
Not in the slightest.
You have the audacity to even ask her. Your naivety never ceases to amaze me. Either that or more front than Brighton.
Well, I can see I'm going to be none the wiser.
Don't you even have a clue?
Not in the slightest.
Unbelievable! You abandoned me on our anniversary. You come home late.
What?
You... At 10 o'clock in the morning.
If you hadn't dropped off in the living room, you would have noticed what time I really did come home.
Oh, and you didn't think of waking me.
I didn't have the heart. And if I'd known you were going to behave like this, I most certainly wouldn't have gone out to buy a croissant.
In last night's clothes.
I was hardly going to spend hours changing just to go and buy a few croissants.
And the makeup?
I went straight to bed. You know, the meeting last night...
Oh, forgive me. I didn't realize.
I was tired. These things happen.
Tired? I apologize for not realizing how just exhausting it must be selling those plastic boxes. And the croissants?
They'd run out.
Oh, it's the thought that counts.
So what did you do?
Oh, suddenly you're interested in what's wrong.
Okay, so I don't give a damn. But seeing as you're so determined to feel sorry for yourself, I thought I might at least try and show a little compassion. Surely you don't begrudge me for going out and seeing people from time to time, do you? It's not my fault if you never want to go anywhere or see anyone. So don't criticize me for having a social life and for not sharing it with you.
All these nights out can't be that much fun, surely.
They suit me perfectly.
So I see. They even seem to suit you more than a candlelit supper with your loving husband.
You're far too romantic, dear.
A fault I intend to keep.
So?
So what?
So what did you do?
I became a murderer. I killed time.
I can see you didn't kill it alone.
Meaning?
There are two glasses in the sink.
Unbelievable! So you do know where the kitchen sink is. I couldn't have wished for a better anniversary present.
Age is bitter to you.
Not at all. And yes, there are two glasses. One can't think of everything. I remember to make the bed and completely overlooked the two glasses.
There's no need for sarcasm.
It was amazing.
Oh, please. If it was true, you'd have been in a much better mood this morning.
You think so? Coming back to the reality of our sad little life would have been more than enough to calm even the wildest of passions.
And that's how you define 8 years of marriage.
9, but I'll let you off, since the last one you did celebrate was the 8th.
Rupert. Rupert, darling, look. I'm really, really sorry about last night. So who was it?
Who cares? I simply decided to have my own little reunion in private. It was quite fun. So much so that I might just be tempted to attend one of yours.
I can't see a group of 5 housewives with one man being all that much fun.
I'm not so sure. I think I'd enjoy it, purely from a research point of view.
Nothing goes on at all, and besides, darling, I'm there to sell to them, not to talk with them.
But then I wouldn't be so lonely. I'd be with you. And anyway, how come you never hold one at home?
That could be arranged. But strangely, I'm a lot more persuasive in other people's homes.
More at ease without me, you mean?
In a word, yes.
Then you wouldn't feel at ease concluding your little deals.
That's right.
Well then, not another word on the matter.
So, what was your meeting all about?
Pest elimination. although I'm afraid the poor man left empty-handed. Speaking of which, how profitable was your evening?
Not very.
Maybe you should think of diversifying.
I'm not giving up just yet. And besides, darling, it isn't as though we need the money.
Well, as long as you're enjoying yourself.
Oh yes, I'm definitely having fun.
So I see. Even talk about seems to bring a twinkle to your eye. Hello.
Hello. Rick Pugh calling back as promised.
Just a second. I didn't expect you to call back.
Oh, I always keep my word.
Who's that, darling?
Nothing. It's about a contract.
Nicely put. Should I call you back?
No, it'll be fine. We just won't be able to discuss things in too much detail.
I'm in the shower, darling. I've taken the phone. I'm waiting for a client to call and confirm a meeting for tonight.
Yeah, that'll make a change.
So have you had a chance to think about my offer?
I have indeed, and I'm very interested. But there's still a problem with the terms. I can't accept
it. Let's not discuss this over the phone. There's always a solution. I know we'll find some common ground.
Well, then, as soon as my wife knows what time her lover will be expecting his delivery this evening, I'll call you back. I have your number. Oh, speak of the devil. Looks like we know sooner than I thought.
You won't regret this.
I don't doubt that for a second.
I'm going out tonight, darling, but I'll be back in time for dinner.
Don't make promises you've no intention of keeping.
I promise. And we can make up for last night.
Yeah, whatever you say. My place, 6 o'clock.
I'll be there at 5.
Interesting proposition.
Unique. One that could change my life forever. And yours too, darling.
Lovely.
As a matter of fact, your very future depends on the outcome of this deal.
Well then, darling, make the right decision. And I won't let anything stand in your way.
Well then, darling, if I have your blessing, my mind is already made up.
When does it all start?
Oh, it's all very hush-hush for the moment.
It can't be that secret.
Well, yes, and of course you know how superstitious I always am until the deed is done. Mm-hmm. But trust me, darling, you'll be the first one to find out.
Well, then, I won't insist.
Probably for the better. Drink, darling?
Lovely, darling. I'll have my usual.
Alrighty. Red or white?
Red.
Coming up. There you go, darling.
Thank you, darling. To a promising future.
To your very good health.
I will follow him. Follow him wherever he may go.
I love it.
Where he goes,
do I owe the pleasure?
Didn't we have an appointment?
Yes, but how long have you been here for?
Well, since 5 o'clock. I hate being late.
Then you must have...
met your charming wife, yes.
And?
We spoke briefly, yes.
May I ask about what?
Oh, this and that. She was running late. She seemed to know about our little appointment and asked me to wait inside.
And she didn't ask any questions?
She's a woman.
So what did you say?
Oh, I told her I was here to discuss you directing an opera.
And?
She just shrugged her shoulders, almost in disappointment. I do hope I didn't put my foot in my mouth.
No, it'll be all right. At least you didn't go into any details.
Well, we did discuss classical music for a couple minutes. Thankfully, she didn't seem any more enlightened on the subject than I.
No surprises there.
Really?
Believe me, cinema, literature, even cooking or knitting, the conversation would have been just as limited.
Really?
I bet you know even more about her beloved Tupperware than her. Her only two fields of expertise seem to be in spending my hard-earned cash and fooling around. Probably the only two things I didn't have to teach her.
How about we get down to business?
Yes, the quicker we get this thing over with, the better.
But before we do, may I be so bold to ask what brought about such a quick decision?
Well, simply realizing that there is a permanent solution to what's become an intolerable situation. When she came in last night, my mind was made up. There's only so much anyone can forgive.
I see! That famous last straw.
Oh, that camel's back has been broken so many times before. I don't know how it still manages to crawl across the desert. That's my marriage.
Well, apart from the price, nothing's holding you back?
Nothing at all, but $100,000.
Ah, money.
You make this sound as if it's not an obstacle. Then again, I guess it's not when you're on the receiving end.
Oh, I'm just the middleman.
Now, that may be, but I'm sure you'd see my point if it was coming out of your pockets.
Quite, but one has to invest in order to reap the benefits.
But it's outrageous. Mm-hmm. And how is this supposed to work anyhow? Mm-hmm. Yes. I decided to spend $100,000 just before my wife's assassination. Don't you find that a little suspicious? I thought you were guaranteeing I'd be above all that. It just doesn't add up.
You could always fake a kidnapping.
Oh, the police aren't that stupid. Mm-hmm. Who's going to pay a ransom without informing them first?
I don't agree. They could discover a body. They could interrogate you. Then all you'd have to admit is that she'd been kidnapped and you were about to pay the ransom.
You make it sound so simple.
Oh, but it is. The only difficult thing about lying is just remaining consistent. You just have to convince yourself. Hmm. What color is my jacket?
Black.
It's blue.
No, it's black. Step into the light.
Okay, black. That is, now it's black to me too, you see? Your conviction on what you perceive the truth to be has convinced me.
But this is all very risque, and I'm sure your list of satisfied clients is somewhat impressive, although they're all from anonymous sources.
You know, actually, that's navy blue. I'm sorry, you were saying?
So where does this method come from, anyhow?
A collection of secret diaries from some of the cleverest murderers in history. From the infamous to the discreet, initiated by none other than the infamous Bluebeard.
Isn't that a French children's fairy tale?
Indeed it is, just as the Bible is our very own fairy tale for grown-ups. Yet how many of its readers doubt the existence of Christ? The stories have been tweaked to iron out the more gory details. Everything else is rigorously authentic, except the color of the beard, of course.
I see. But his crimes hardly went unpunished.
He managed 7 murders out of 8, which is quite a respectable score.
But hardly perfect.
Well, I give you that, but that had nothing to do with the method. He was unmasked by his own inability to stay on track. Bluebeard became, how should we put it? Far too attached to his victim's remains, which caused him to throw caution to the wind or into the wardrobe, as the case may be.
Looking at it that way.
And that's the way it should be looked at. Cheers.
Cheers. So, who else is on this honors list?
Well, there's that other Frenchman, dear Landreau, who managed to avoid the fatal error of his predecessor.
Didn't stop him from coming to a similar end, the death sentence, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, but that was greed that got the best of him. You see, his motivation wasn't so much to remove his wives, but to strip them of their wealth. Greed does rather tend to ruin what could have otherwise been a perfect crime.
Yet you still use him as an example?
Indeed. Burning his victims taught us so much about the art of covering our tracks.
Well, of course, but one would need a chimney.
My point is just how much we can learn from experience or our predecessors' mistakes.
I see. But I just hope your method has learned from those mistakes.
Indeed, it has.
Well, can you give me at least a few examples that it has?
Of course.
And they are?
Well, their successes are rarely publicized amongst our more popular criminals for the simple fact that the success of their crimes have allowed them to remain in blissful anonymity. No one knows who they are, but everyone knows their crimes.
So you can't tell me who they are?
Sorry. Well, the clients get to know more. Trust does have a price.
Well, trust is exorbitant.
So nothing I can say is going to convince you to invest.
Nothing.
That is not what you told me yesterday. You even asked me back here today.
Well, you did suggest that there might be another solution.
Oh, there's always another solution. You could either continue to live with your wife or to remove her. Now, you could divorce her or kill her. Now, I still think you're leaning more towards that non-legal method. Unless, of course, you're planning on starting divorce procedures. After all, there's nothing quite as mortifying as a nice, bloody divorce.
Interesting argument, but it doesn't offer any solutions.
Oh. Money is not everything, Rupi.
Really? Do go on.
I assume you've heard of LETS. L-E-T-S? Local Exchange Trading System?
That's bartering, if I'm not mistaken.
In a nutshell, yes. Knowledge, skills, or some sort of service you can provide can be transformed into a currency which can be used to purchase a service of similar value.
I perfectly understand, but in what way would that be useful to our little business deal? Whatever could I possibly do that's worth $100,000? I'm hardly going to sell my soul to the devil. Not sure he'd want it anyhow.
Don't underestimate yourself. But don't joke about that kind of thing either. It makes my blood curdle.
You can't seriously tell me you believe in that nonsense.
One can never be too careful.
Okay. So what do I have to do? But I'm warning you. I don't care for eternal debts. If you think I'll agree to work for you for the rest of my life, you can think again. Not even part-time.
Nothing of the kind. Just one single task in exchange.
Only one?
Skeptical?
No. I'll follow your advice this time. I'll bet with caution.
That's an understandable reaction. However, I do guarantee you that after performing this one single task, you'll have unlimited access to our method.
And what would this task entail?
Kill my wife.
What?
Kill my wife.
I presume you're joking.
Not in the slightest.
How am I supposed to go about killing your wife when I'm still needing your method in order to kill mine?
But this is very different. You don't know the victim. Nothing connects you to her at all. This is much more straightforward.
I see. Forgive me. Murder's not one of my fields of expertise.
Trust me, you'll get the hang of it. You just need to take your first step.
Oh, only the first step. And is there ever a second step? Or would it be like taking one's first step off a cliff?
Oh, why all this pessimism, Rupi?
I don't make snap decisions. What you're asking
just
me is
to... Just think of it as a rehearsal. A little practice run just to get a little confidence in your actions.
Well, if that's the case, why would I even need your method in the first place?
To cover your tracks! Otherwise, I agree, from a technical point of view, wouldn't really be of that much use at all. However, if you don't kill my wife, how would you discover the best way to do away with yours?
That's a hit below the belt.
But I never said I was a saint. And you're at liberty to refuse and remain at the mercy of your wife.
This is no ordinary deal.
Trust me, it's a first for me too.
Unless, of course, you've already been whittled several times.
Nothing of the kind. This is a one-off arrangement.
So, why me?
Like I said earlier, I want to help. I was touched by your predicament.
Touched enough to want me to commit murder?
Well...
You do have a strange way of taking pity on someone.
I do have to admit that selling all the murder to the husbands and wives of my clients over the years has made the concept much more appealing to me.
I see. Tired of one's spouse seems to be catching.
It's infectious.
But I don't follow. You could always just leave her. Why her?
Impossible.
Nothing's impossible.
Exactly! So why should murder be?
All right. I'm convinced.
Convinced?
That you're a born salesman.
It's very amusing. Thank you.
You're welcome. Mm. Now, why murder?
Because I can't just leave her.
Is she rich?
If only. She's sick.
Oh.
That is, she tries her utmost to contract every ailment known to man. And when that doesn't work, she invents all sorts of asymptomatic afflictions.
So?
So? It's a matter of principle.
Principle?
Oh, you seem surprised.
Forgive me, but wanting to murder one's wife is a strange way of having principle.
Well, forgive me, but I think you're hardly in a position to judge, do you?
Touché.
You can't just leave a sick woman. I couldn't anyway.
I see. Scruples. How very honorable.
Not at all.
Well then, why not?
Because one can so easily become the victim. The heartless, the coward. Titles aren't exactly relish the thought of being credited with, so you wait for death to pluck her from you. Weeks, months, years. Although my patience is wearing a little thin.
I see. But surely you could give destiny a little nudge and take care of what Mr. Grim Reaper seems to have overlooked, with you being so well up on the knowledge and everything, no?
True. I could easily acquire the necessary knowledge.
Well then?
That's hardly enough. The one thing I could almost certainly never acquire is the courage.
Well, then tell me something. You don't work for... There is one detail that escapes me. You don't work for yourself.
No.
So then, you're not the creator of said method.
No.
So then how do you explain to your employer that you've sold one in exchange for something that only you will benefit from?
Ha, touche! Aren't we the clever one?
Not nearly as clever as your good self, I'm sure.
You're so right. And I do have an answer to your question.
I can't wait.
Well, you will understand, of course, that I cannot possibly provide you with the official version. However, strictly off the record, in exchange for a favor, for you helping me eliminate my wife.
What you're asking me is not part of the deal. I would be incapable of killing a complete stranger.
Well, if that's all that's holding you back, I'm sure I can arrange a quick meeting. However, I'm quite sure the picture I could paint would be more than enough to convince you.
Really?
Our relationship was doomed from the very beginning. I was well and truly stitched up.
How long have you been married for?
2 years.
Is that all?
Feels like a life sentence.
So she really did stitch you up.
I wish there was another way of putting it. But yeah.
Well, there are more politically correct ways of putting it, but getting stitched up, my good man, is the very essence of what marriage is all about. One is baited and enticed with promises of forbidden delights, and then, just as you take that first tiny nibble, bang! Down comes the trap door, and on goes the wedding ring.
It was just one uncomplicated night of pleasure.
That's all it takes.
By the time I realized it was too late,
ouch!
I had to face my responsibilities.
Well, you could have refused to believe her or ask for some kind of proof.
Oh, my principles got the better of me once again, Rupee. Not even 2 months after that, we were sitting before the register.
Ooh, that's soon.
And 1 month after that... Oh, darling, did I mention the miscarriage?
No!
I'd never truly found out if she'd been pregnant, but it didn't matter. The deed was done. I'd been well and truly done. I know I married her out of guilt, but to this day, I still don't know what her reasons were.
I see. But to go as far as wanting to have her killed...
At least then I would be guilty of something.
So you have a plan?
We'll find one. I knew I could count on your wisdom.
I don't know about wisdom. All I know is that you've somehow managed to reawaken my desire to put an end to something that's become too unbearable for words. I no longer have a choice. You made me realize there actually could be a light at the end of this proverbial tunnel.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, what are you planning on doing?
The sooner the better. Time to think would only result in my change my mind, contemplating both of us.
Well, now, all we need to do is just have one signature right here
but
on the dotted line.
I thought we'd have a gentleman's agreement. Why leave a trace?
Putting things in writing makes one much more inclined to honor an agreement, don't you think? Just one little signature on the dotted line right here, and in the event of my wife remaining of this world, you agreed to buy our whole range of products.
Huh, You can't lose.
Well, I will have to compensate myself for all the time you'll have wasted if you call me back here for nothing.
Fair enough. And I suppose I could always make very good use of my your poison to spice up my wife's salad dress.
Satisfaction all round, so if you don't mind.
Hold on a second. What about the small print?
Trust me, Rupee. This is an agreement based on trust. You don't have to worry about a thing.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So, what's the plan?
Well, that depends on whether you'd like to start with one of our more tried and trusted methods or something a little more original.
Well, I'd rather want to avoid anything too theatrical to begin with.
Oh, then we should start with cinema. You've seen Dial M for Murder.
Hasn't everyone? But I'm not sure that's a very good example.
Well, why not?
Well, if I remember correctly, things didn't exactly go as planned.
No. That's down to bad luck. A slight hitch, the wrong screenwriter. The criminal can't be perceived to be the winner, just wouldn't do. It'd be morally unacceptable. The audience would resent the whole film. Trust me, that's the only reason.
Yes, but in this case,
who would know? Everyone assumes things are fine between my wife and I. That's why when you kill her, I'll be above all suspicion. And because we just exchanged one favor for another, no money exchanged hands, no one can accuse me of paying someone to do it for me.
Well, putting it that way, I guess bartering does have its advantages, and not just for the sales tax.
Let's recapitulate.
If we must.
I call my wife on the phone to ensure my alibi. Then, when she least expects it, you...
I hope it's not a cordless phone.
I strongly advise against strangulation. It's very time-consuming. It's extremely tiring, and you never know. She could be a black belt in some sort of...
So what then?
Well, a domestic accident. Electrocution, falling out of a window. The possibilities are endless. One's own home can quite often be more dangerous than the most desperate of husbands. The choice is yours.
Yes, but by their very definition, accidents are somewhat difficult to provoke.
Sometimes a little nudge is all that's necessary. I'm sure you'll think of something.
Well, at least one of us is.
So, when are you planning on getting down to business?
Tomorrow. Terrell should be little more than a distant souvenir.
Well then, I'll see you tomorrow.
You see, darling, it wasn't one at all. Oh, you're still here.
I'm just leaving.
Did you make the deal? My husband can be so terribly demanding.
Oh.
I do hope he wasn't too difficult.
Everything is fine. We managed to find some common ground. Hmm?
Yes, everything's agreed. He was just leaving.
Really? I was just about to invite you to stay for dinner. We could discuss your little deal.
Oh, but you know what? I would be delighted.
But he has a previous engagement, isn't that so?
Yes, but it's not all that important.
Yes, but we fully understand it's just not polite to cancel these things at the last minute.
Oh, darling, you and your silliness.
And where are yours? Some other time.
Oh, I can't see that happening.
What? Why ever not?
One never knows what life has in store for us.
He's an extremely busy man.
Well, some other time it is then.
We would hate to be late on our account. She might get upset.
Oh, a woman.
Yes. Goodbye.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
So what?
Did you make the deal?
Yes.
Well, I can hardly see what all the fuss is about. It's hardly the first time you've been offered this kind of thing.
This one is different.
So I see. You always refused in the past. It must have been an offer you couldn't refuse.
That's one way of putting it.
So, how much?
How much what?
Money. How much is it going to make?
Money! How much money? Well, let's just say you'll never have to worry about money ever again.
That's already the case, isn't it, darling?
Yes, but things could change overnight. This way, you'll be set up for life.
Mm-hmm. So when does it all start?
Oh, I just have to tie up a few things.
Strike while the iron's hot, darling. Looks like this would be far too good an opportunity to miss up.
Don't worry, darling. If I allow this opportunity to slip by, I'll never forgive myself. Speaking of which, how was your evening?
Oh, it was fabulous.
So I see. This is new.
What?
The necklace.
Oh, that, yes.
Well, someone seems to have exceeded herself.
Like never before.
Well, enjoy while you still can.
I'm sorry?
I mean, well, you might not always be this successful.
Darling, you're such a pessimist.
Oh, just being realistic. I mean, today you've come home draped in glory, and tomorrow could be a whole nother story. Aww. It's looking overcast. It's been sunny all day long, and now it looks like it's gonna rain. You see, darling, all good things do tend to come to an end.
This new contract of yours has hardly made you a bundle of joy.
You're right. Life's too short. But things are starting to look up.
So where were we? It was very naughty of me to stand you up like that last night. How could I ever make it up to you?
You'll be forever in my debt.
Anything, darling. Even if I'm paying for it for the rest of my life.
Be careful what you wish for, darling.
What are we waiting for?
What's the point of no return? No backward glances or games of make-believe for a time. Or thought of if or when.
Oh!
No use resisting. Abandon thought and let the dream descend. What raging fire shall flood the soul? What rich desire unlocks it?
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
I've done it.
Oh, did everything go all right? Did you cover your tracks?
All right! If by all right you mean is she dead, then yes, everything is just fine.
Now you're ready to face the music.
I don't know anymore. I just can't bear the thought of rubbing shoulders with death a second time. If only you knew how disgusting I feel.
Oh, please! Don't tell me at any time during the little act. You didn't feel the tiniest rush of adrenaline from that intoxicating, liberating cocktail of fear and pleasure that goes through
your brain. I thought you'd never killed before.
Of course not. But outdoor hunting. Now imagine that same rush one gets. That when all this between life and death is one's trigger finger just as it's about to go off.
How cruel!
Cruel? Might I remind you just killed someone?
I prefer you didn't.
But it'll be our little secret. I'll see you tonight.
No, wait. Hello? Hello?
Whatever's the matter, darling? You're awfully quiet. What's wrong?
Nothing escapes you.
So, what is it that's tormenting you?
I'd rather not talk about it.
You're wrong, darling. Talking helps.
Not when you're always on the receiving end.
Get your own doors.
Don't tempt me.
And you shouldn't be drinking.
Since when has that bothered you before?
It's not good for you. Especially with the state you're in. Why won't you tell me what's wrong?
You're better off not knowing. It's just too mortifying.
I'll take my chances.
A woman died. Right before my eyes.
That's horrible. Did you know her?
Not at all.
Did I?
No. Unless she was one of your clients. Come to think of it, some of your little plastic boxes would have been more than useful to store what's left of her now.
Darling, how can you joke at a time like this?
It's nerves. It's not every day you see a woman plunged to her death from the 8th floor.
It must have been such a shock.
For her, too! I can still hear the sound of her scream. That is, until the silence by the tarmac below and the sound of bones cracking as she hit the ground.
That's horrendous.
Just think about it brings shivers to my spine. Like fingernails on a blackboard.
Mm-hmm. Well, darling, if that's all the effect it's had on you...
To tell you the truth, yes. Mm-hmm. And that's what worries me. Although extremely terrifying, I found it exciting. All that blood splattered all over the ground.
Darling, you're frightening me. You're not being yourself at all.
Really?
Well, yes. But tell me what happened.
You really want to know?
Yes.
You should sit down.
Is it that bad?
Worse.
Bring me a cushion, would you, darling?
With pleasure.
You're an angel.
That's what you think.
Huh?
I really didn't miss a second of her fall.
How is that possible? Falling 8 floors would only take a matter of seconds.
Not at all. I didn't miss a thing. Whole thing from above. I could even see the looks of surprise on the passersby. And then surprise turned into panic. It was all very exciting. Everyone screaming and me watching the whole spectacle from above.
I don't understand.
It's simple. I was in the apartment when she fell.
What? What were you doing there? You don't even know her.
Someone asked me to visit her.
Someone? Who?
Her husband.
What? Why?
They needed a little marriage guidance.
I don't see what that has to do with you.
It's simple. I killed her.
What? Is this some kind of joke?
Not at all.
Why did you kill her?
To keep my side of the deal.
The deal?
And of course, to get the hang of it.
What?
A rehearsal.
A rehearsal for what?
To make sure I get it right. With you!
Ah!
Don't waste your last breath struggling, darling. I've never known you to struggle like this beneath me before. Same as for the last time. my God, Sylvia! I've gone mad! Oh, Sylvia! Just a minute! Who is it?
You're safe.
Aren't you afraid she'll hear us?
Well, if she does, it's of no importance. She already knows. You're too late. I no longer require your services.
Oh, so I see.
Drink?
No, thank you.
I headed to her apartment, pretending to be a new neighbor.
Is that wise?
Well, there was a removal van in front of the building. Somebody was obviously moving in.
Not bad.
Huh. We chatted about this and that, and then I informed her about the water that seemed to be leaking from her balcony.
I'm impressed.
She leaned out and, well, it was surprisingly easy to send her on her way.
Great.
And then I made sure to set up the accident. I sprayed the windows, remembering to spill some of the soapy water onto the footstool. As far as anyone's concerned, she simply slipped while climbing up to clean the windows.
Fantastic.
Your wife is well and truly dead.
Splendid. But that's not why I'm here.
I don't follow.
I have a little confession.
Yes?
You didn't kill my wife.
Oh, I assure you, your wife couldn't be more dead. Believe me, I saw her splattered on the concrete ground.
You don't understand. I'm sure you committed the most perfect of murders, but you didn't kill my wife.
I'm sorry?
Surprise!
Well, I don't care anymore. I don't need you anymore. And if you think I'm going to make amends by becoming some kind of hitman, you can guess again. My wife is dead. That's all that matters as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, I'm not asking you to make amends, Rupee. Just to honor our agreement.
But I did, even though if I was slightly off target.
Yeah, you still don't understand. You were right on target. But that was only part of our agreement.
What are you trying to say?
You promised to sell me your soul.
If this is some kind of sick joke.
Not at all. Not at all. Rick Fuel. R-I-C-F-U-E-L. Or L-U-C-I. Well, how are you with your anagrams, Rupee?
Since when has the devil been a door-to-door salesman?
Old wives' tale.
I always thought he offered eternal youth.
Ever since foul-speak people have become annoyingly prudent. I don't have a wife. I'm not married. And I'm afraid that you killing that poor woman in cold blood as you did has condemned you to entrust me with your soul.
But I'm not dead. Come back some other time.
Oh, you are not dead. Yet.
You're gonna kill me?
I'm afraid I don't have the right or indeed the power to do that.
Well then, that's that.
Somebody else already did it for me.
What do you mean? Who?
Your wife.
My wife?
This one's gonna kill you. Forget the pun. I ran into your wife just before I met you. Unlike your good self, she didn't hesitate one second before signing. She knows all about her little method. However, she does drive a hard bargain. I had to promise her that her lover's wife would be eliminated in exchange. And you did it for me. It's fascinating, isn't it?
I see. Aren't you forgetting one thing?
I don't think so.
My wife is dead. How can she possibly harm me now?
Ah, I see you've never read anything on criminology.
Oh, should I have?
Oh, yes. Because if you had, you'd have learned that the most common way that a woman uses to eliminate someone is poison.
Interesting, but I don't see what that has to do with me.
Why do you think I declined to join you for a drink?
Why, you wanker!
Oh, it's far too late. By the time the ambulance gets here, you'll be mine.
So, there's nothing at all I can do?
Nothing.
So, what's it like in hell?
Oh, don't believe everything you've heard. It's true, it's not that chilly, but the fact that one actually burns in hell is complete speculation by the church. No. It's really a kingdom of vice, decadence, freedom.
Doesn't sound quite that bad.
And it isn't. It's really a paradise for those who wish to go on performing the most wicked deeds long after death. However, there is a downside.
Oh?
Well, you do understand that we can't just accept everyone. We do have a reputation to protect.
So,
I'm afraid it's bad news.
Worse than death and eternal damnation.
It's actually rather ironic.
Ironic?
All that effort to remove your wife was really of no use at all. She condemned herself by killing you. You'll be together for all eternity.
How simple things could have been if only I just loved you.
Everybody for joining us in our little version of hell. It's a little hot in here, so my name is Matt Vladimery, and I've been an actor, been out here for a while. If you like the show, please go to Bière Duc or Fnac, wherever, and please leave a review. And just thank you very much for coming out here. And these are my thanks to Beth, and thanks to Pete.
What's his name?
Yeah, Pete, that guy. And the writer of the play, right back here, and the owner of the theater, David Sauvage.
Yay!
Wrote it in French as well, but it's now in English. So, Beth, you want to take it over?
Sure. Thanks for coming, everybody. Can I have a hand show who came from Meetup?
That's full.
Okay. There were two Meetup groups, in fact. And hikers. Okay, that's everyone. So, if you guys want to go for a drink afterwards, we'll be at the Bowman, which is just next door. Here on the corner.
Where are you
thanks
from?
Very much.
Yeah.
From England. These guys. I guess they. Yeah, I'm an actress. I've been here for 6 years. Thanks for coming.
That's it.
Thank you all for coming. My name is Pete Thias. I'm from the States. I've been in France for almost 23 years now. Normally I'm involved with musical theater, and this is the first time I've got a chance to actually perform in a satirical comedy drama, and so I'm having a lot of fun. Thanks to my co-stars, Beth and Matt, thank you very much, and thank you, David, as well. Again, if you like it, of course you'll like it.
Yeah.
Tell your friends.
He's a big guy, you should like it, really.
Also, I'd like to say that Beth's dad is with us tonight, so...
Hey, wow.
You can be very proud of your daughter, we are. So, okay, so we'll see you shortly for some drinks, okay? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.